Welcome to Crypto Tutors. We are humanizing cryptocurrency and blockchain and are bringing the best trailblazers and success stories like Isaiah Jackson, Tanya Evans, Ian Bellina, Cleve Messidor, and Tinashe Nitaganga on the Crypto Couch. Click subscribe and the bell to be the first to watch the latest interviews every single week.
Balancing all of these, you know, juggling everything that you have to juggle, how, you know, are you able to manage women in particular that are trying to kind of get their footing across all of the different hats that they wear?
Yeah, I mean, I think don't put too much pressure on yourself to make all of the hats fit and be perfect all of the time. I had a colleague reach out to me recently who just had a baby with similar challenges, and we just kind of talked through some of my learnings. And, you know, we have to give each other a lot of grace and a lot of space to figure things out, especially new moms. I have a lot of empathy for that. You know, earlier on in my career, I worked for an ambassador, Susan Rice. And I remember sitting in on an interview she gave when somebody asked her something similar. And she said she couldn't do what she's doing now without the husband that she had and the partner she married. And, you know, this is an incredibly educated, well-rounded woman. And I took that really to heart, and I've married very well. And I have a great partner in life and in home who allows me to really lean into work when I need to. And we share a lot of household responsibilities. And so I don't have to take on the second shift like a lot of women do. I have a great team here at Gemini. So I started as a one-person team. But even then, I felt like there was a lot of support from my colleagues in the marketing function, in the office of CEOs, other places, when they recognized that I needed a little bit more bandwidth. I've been able to build that team out. So hiring smart, hiring the right people who are going to, you know, have the same passion, same conviction, and want the same level of success that you have is really incredible. And I think really being realistic that some days you're going to do certain things better than others. Some days I'm going to be a better Gemini employee than I am mom. And that doesn't always feel great at the end of the day. But if I give myself space to make mistakes and I give myself space to be less than perfect, then, you know, I'm not as anguished at the end of the day if I miss something or I didn't get to see my child for dinner, or, you know, I wasn't on the last conference call that I needed to be on because I needed to do something at home.
Such a great perspective to have because, you know, there's no such thing as perfection. And I feel as though a lot of us kind of strive for it and then get disappointed when we don't, you know, achieve that end. But, you know, you've been at Gemini for a few years now, and you really could have gone, or you could be really at any organization. And so to know how deliberate you are and intentional you are with how you govern, you know, personal life, professional life, et cetera, tell us a bit more about what is it that is happening within your organization that you know has excited you for all of these years. I'm wearing my flames, you know, not just because you're a trailblazer, because you clearly are on fire. There's a lot of fervor in the work that you do. So yeah. Tell us about it. Tell us about, you know, how that's going overall.
Yeah, well, Gemini is certainly on fire, and so is the industry, which is really exciting. You know, I joined Gemini in 2018 when the price of Bitcoin was actually on the decline, and it's a very different time now. We all saw the bull run the past year and a lot of new folks coming into the industry and coming into crypto, which is really exciting. A mix of retail investors and institutional investors and friends that have known what I've been doing for a living are now asking me advice on, you know, should I buy ETH? Should I buy Bitcoin? Should I sell? How long do I hold? So I think just as an industry, the moment that we've all kind of wanted to happen is here, where we're getting a lot more mainstream credibility. And Gemini has been building towards this for years. Like Cameron and Tyler Winklevoss, the founders of Gemini, have been laying such a strong foundation since the company was founded in 2014, launched in 2015, really building the infrastructure that we needed in place to service these kind of customers, whether it's a retail investor like you or I, or a big bank or an institutional customer that really wants to get exposure to cryptocurrency. So having that foundation was really important. And then building the right products on top of that. So this year we've, you know, announced an acquisition of BlockRise, which allows us to launch a credit card, which will be coming soon. So that means—
I'm on the wait list.
Yeah, I am too. That means you could just invest while you spend. You can go take your credit card and, you know, use it for your everyday purchases and then choose which Bitcoin you, or which crypto, I should say, you want to earn a reward in. And Gemini now, we have listed more than 50 cryptocurrencies. And not long ago, we had five. So we have scaled tremendously in the kind of tokens that we offer, expanded into areas like the UK and Singapore, and we'll continue to look at our global expansion. We launched Gemini Earn, which is a way to earn interest on the crypto holdings, and all of that during a global pandemic. So it's been a pretty fast moving environment for us, but I think that's really reflective of the crypto industry as a whole.
You're going to have to let us know what your hourly rate is, because we need you in Crypto Tutors to be tutoring. We have tutors.
I should say, how could I forget? Thank you. Education. So education is tremendously important. And we invested in this resource called Cryptopedia. We launched it in 2021. So I had to think about what year we're in. But we, you know, brought in a team of folks to really build that content out. And it's open access to all things crypto. So whether you want to begin with Bitcoin or dive deeper into DeFi, just come to Cryptopedia and, you know, hopefully we'll have enough content there that'll get you through your journey, whether you want to trade or just continue to learn more. So we launched that this year too.
And you know, that was part of the allure when we were, you know, starting to have conversations around where the synergies lie between, you know, our respective organizations, that education component really, I think kind of solidified that this was a partnership that was like, you know, meant to be. And you've been, you know, tremendous partners to us, a, you know, phenomenal, you know, resource, you know, consistently offering resources to us, guidance, et cetera. So, you know, it kind of brings me to my next question. You know, you obviously, you know, have so many things going on at Gemini. The industry is moving at like lightning speed. Kind of funny, because you know, Bitcoin Lightning Network.
Yeah, I see what you did there.
So here's the thing, right? Like, there's a lot of conversation around, you know, crypto and the possibility of closing the wealth gap for marginalized communities. And I think that, you know, the idea sounds very enticing and exciting. But, you know, tell us whether or not you think that that's a possibility. And within the organ, within the institutions that are playing within the space, but then also from a retail perspective, like, you know, marginalized communities globally, do they really stand a chance to harness the power of crypto? What are your thoughts on that?
It's a good topic to really dive into, because I think we as an industry have a really big aspirations. I mean, Gemini's mission right now is to empower the individual through crypto. And you could really take that and apply it in many different ways. And I certainly have a point of view for myself and what that means for me as somebody who started to take my own initiative in investing and feel that power and what that means. I think in terms of banking the unbanked or closing that gap, there's a lot of opportunity there. And we're still really, really early on in crypto. And you're seeing in developed countries where they're starting to adopt digital assets and alternative currencies. And we're going to, you know, have to give it time to see if it's going to take hold. But I think there's a lot of opportunity. And we do have to be realistic, though, in our limitations. And, you know, as a centralized exchange, you still are required to have a bank account to be a Gemini customer. So for us, we have to think about what is our contribution to the broader ecosystem. So the short answer is, I think there's a tremendous opportunity.
Want to learn more? Visit CryptoTutors.com.